Dear brothers in Islam, let the one who repented during the month of repentance never go back to sinning after he repented to Allah Azza wa Jal. Let the one who was steadfast on performing the acts of obedience remain steadfast on them after Ramadan. For this life is very short, and the gate of repentance is widely open for you. It will not be closed unless you see the angel of death or the angels of torture when they approach you when you are dying, or when your soul reaches your throat, or when the sun rises from the west. If you repented to Allah during Ramadan, remain steadfast on repentance. Do not go back to sinning. If you receive some whisperings from the devil to go back to sinning, say, I don't want to go to hellfire. I want to go to paradise. Think about the consequences of committing these sins. And remember what the scholar said, that whoever disobeys Allah while he's laughing, Allah will admit him into hellfire while he's crying. And the one who obeys Allah while he's crying out of fear of Allah and glorification, Allah will admit him into paradise and he will be laughing and happy. This life is very short. It's not worth it that you disobey Allah Azza wa Jal and you put yourself in a situation that you might be tortured in the hereafter for committing that sin. All the pleasures of this life will perish quickly, will vanish. So do not rely on them. Rather, make your pleasures in performing the acts of obedience, in obeying Allah. One of the great followers of the companions, known as Thabit al-Bunani, used to stay at night awake, praying and reciting Quran, and used to fast most of the days. Even in the long and hot days, he used to fast them. He's the one who said, I was struggling with myself to pray for 20 years. Then I started enjoying the prayer for the following 20 years. He was steadfast on performing the optional prayers on top of the obligatory prayers. The one who placed him in his grave said, I swear by Allah, when I placed Thabit al-Bunani in his grave, in the lahad, which is a cavity in the direction of the Qibla, I was putting the bricks to cover it. One brick fell inside. I tried to grab it, and I was astonished when I saw Thabit al-Bunani standing in his grave praying. I called my friend and said to him, come and see what I'm seeing. He said, don't talk about it. They buried him. They went to his daughter and they asked her, what did he used to do in this life? She said, what did you see? And they told her. She said to them, my father Thabit, for 50 years, not 5 days or 5 months or 5 years, for 50 years he would stay at night praying, and just before dawn he would supplicate Allah, asking Allah by saying, oh Allah, if you have ever granted anyone the virtue of praying in the grave, grant me this virtue. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't reject his supplication. His supplication was fulfilled and he was praying in his grave. And this is not impossible, for it was confirmed in the Sahih Hadith that when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took the night journey from Al-Masjid Al-Haram to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. The Prophet said, I passed by the grave of Prophet Musa alayhi salam, and I saw him standing in his grave praying. Some people cannot remain steadfast on performing the obligations after Ramadan. They pray during Ramadan, then they stop praying after Ramadan. They stop committing sins in Ramadan, they go back to sinning after Ramadan. They cannot be steadfast for a short period of time in performing the obligations and avoiding the sins. This righteous person was steadfast on the optional prayers and optional fasting for 50 years. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us like those people and to grant us a good ending. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best.